Shalom, shalom. Shalom, shalom, first and foremost. Giving infinite praises, glory, and honor unto Yahweh Ba'ashim El Shah Ba'ashim Hakudash. Giving double honors to our apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Shalom, salutation to you sincere Akims across the four winds, pushing this truth with sincerity of heart. I'm your fellow servant, Kasama Gun from the DC camp. Coming at you through the spirit and power of Yahweh Ba'ashim El Shah Ba'ashim Hakudash for the elect. And this is another installment of the Watchtower. As you know, the Watchtower represents where? That's the location in which the watchman would stay and always warned the nation and warned the castle or the kingdom of an impending invasion from the enemy. And when it comes to the nation of Israel, so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Native Americans, a nation that's been in captivity in the virgin daughter of Babylon, aka these United States of America, for over 500 years. Our nation, the watchmen, the men that you see out in the highways and the edges, right? Primarily of course, Great Millstone, because we know through the Spirit that the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, and His Son, Yahweh Shah, through the Holy Spirit, Ruhakwadash, are dealing with us, and we bring in His gospel. Day in and day out, week in and week out, in season and out of season, constantly warning our people of the chaos, the death, the destruction, and the judgment that's coming upon us, and that's coming upon this land, you know, and also the salvation and the deliverance of the elect, all right? The 1/3 and the 144,000 spoken of in the book of Revelation, the 7th chapter. And now in this installment of the Watchtower, the subtitle will be The Virgin or Babylon, Babylon's, something to the effect of Babylon's backbone snaps. I like that. I'm going to use that. And the reason why is because, as you know, your backbone is a very intricate part of your body. It's what pretty much holds your upper body and your lower body together. It's your backbone, you know. And, you know, once your backbone goes out and it snaps, you're basically done. You know, it doesn't necessarily mean that you're dead, but as far as your future is pretty much over with. You know, you're just going to be laying down in the bed some damn way and going to be taken care of by somebody else. And, you know, so in this case, right, dealing with the virgin daughter of Babylon, you have the news right here. This is out of the AmericanFaith.com, but you can find this in a lot of articles. I think that even CNN posted something similar, and basically it says over 200 business owners filed federal class action lawsuit against New York City mayor. This will be the first domino to hashtag end COVID tyranny nationwide. And basically business owners, which is your upper middle class citizen in the United States of America, mostly upper middle class, because they're the ones that own businesses, and they, you know, they're the entrepreneurs, the movers and the shakers. They're not super rich, but they got enough, and they make sure everybody else, well, not everybody else, most people are hired. All right. So when you go to school to get your degree, to just be a worker, a lot of times you end up working for, you know, one of these individuals, these business owners. All right. From 400, 500 companies down to the local business store, the local boutique. You know what I'm saying? So these are the people that are the backbone of the U.S. And they tend to be in a very, very high tax bracket, because they don't get the benefits of the super rich. Meaning the super rich in the United States, which begins with, you know, some of the guys that, you know, the Bill Gates and so on and so forth, that make deals with the Rothschilds. But the Rothschilds are beyond super rich. Those, the 13 families, the Rothschilds, the Rockefeller, those are the international bankers. Those are the ones who own the planet Earth right now under the control of the spiritual demon Satan. So I'm not even counting them. I'm talking about strictly the U.S., and Babylon. And if you're talking about the latter, as far as financially, people that are called the 1% in the U.S., they don't really, they pay next to no taxes, because they always have loopholes. But the majority of taxes are paid by the backbone of the United States, which is the business owners. That's the reason why, if you were to wage a war, a financial war against the U.S., you would want to go after the middle class or the upper middle class or business owners. And as we know, the international bankers have decided to wage war, right? Because the New World Order, part of the New World Order plans and Agenda 2030, the U.S. as a sovereign nation is not a part of those plans. So this place was always meant to be done away with, regardless. Okay, so now what you got going on is that, but the CV-19, things have been going pretty bad for them. The backbone has snapped, you know, on a lot of lockdown, you know, shut their businesses down, you know, and the government took over and basically said, you're not going to be able to run your business for almost 2 years. It's been about 2 years now. So a lot of these business owners are still not able to open up their businesses because of these draconian measures. So therefore now they're on the attack. They're snapping. Okay? They're snapping. So this is business owners in New York City are banding together to end CV tyranny and fight back the government sanctioned segregation ushered in by unconstitutional vaccine mandates and in a class action federal lawsuit that will likely be litigated in the Supreme Court. So they taking this is over 200 businesses have banded together, man, and they're taking this thing to the Supreme Court. So it's going to be a fight. But are they going to win? Absolutely not. They don't stand a chance in the world, man. The three branches of government have been taken over by the Rockefeller and the Rothschilds, dating back to I'm talking about 1913, man. I mean, the executive branch, the legislative branch, and the judicial branch, which is the Supreme Court, the judiciary branch, they are all bought and paid for by the Rothschilds, Rockefeller, you know, international bankers. So these business owners are wasting their time, you know what I'm saying? But I understand why they're doing what they're doing, you know? I mean, they got to fight for their land, got to fight for their business. They got to fight for their future. The problem is, unfortunately for them, our future, you know, us as Israelites, is the reason why they are going through this nightmare. Because ultimately, Yahweh Bashem El Shah, which that's the power that created this whole universe, and his son, the heir, who owns everything, really, spiritually, you know, they're taking this place down. And they're using the left-hand side to do that. So these business owners are wasting their time, but I understand why they're doing it, but they're still going to lose, because ultimately this is all part of the transition of the nation of Israel, the elect of Israel, getting the F up out of here. Okay. So now it says, on August 17, de Blasio signed emergency executive order 225 mandating all indoor establishment not permit a patron full or part-time employee, intern, volunteer, or contractors to enter covered premises without displaying proof of vaccination and identification bearing the same identifying information as the proof of vaccination. Wow, man. So basically, you know, your passport, your jab ID becomes your regular ID. And that was always the plan, you know. I mean, we always knew that was the plan, you know, passport, vaccination passports and everything. Like, that was always the goal. That's agenda 2021. I mean, they're actually behind. I think that the elites believe that by the end of summer, that would be really all over and established. And I think that the pushback that's going on from a lot of the people that are waking up and trying to call themselves fighting the New World Order, which they're wasting their time, because fighting the New World Order is kind of like, in a way, fighting against God and the left-hand side. So you're wasting your time. You know what I'm saying? You don't understand, you know, this is chess, man. This is chess, you know. But the nations are going to fight. Esau, Edom, the average Edomite, who's completely oblivious of the big picture, he's going to fight against his own rulers, the rulers of his own nation, because he's totally oblivious. But us as Israelite, we got the scoop. We know what's going on. You know, a nation divided against itself cannot stand. So we can't, we have to continue to cheer on when we see these things happening. Like, we want more draconian measures. We want more tyranny. We want things to continue to go down the route of 1944, 1945 Germany. That's what we want. That's what we're supposed to pray for. Okay, we're not supposed to pray for peace and things to go back to normal. Normal means eternal slavery for so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Native Americans. That's what normal means to us. So we don't want things to go back to normal. We want things to continue down a road that is going, because we know where this is going to lead according to the scriptures. Okay, so I'm not going to read the whole thing, you know, and... But yeah, that's what's going on, man. The backbone of the U.S. is snapping, you know, spiritually, mentally, you know, they're snapping. And when your backbone snaps, you got a problem. The whole body got a big problem. Okay, so now let's get the precepts to back that up. As first, let's go to Jeremiah 50 and 16, what I always call the COVID scripture. Jeremiah 50 and 16, cut off the sword from Babylon. Babylon is a code name in Jeremiah for these United States. The sower is the business owners. All right. The business owners. How did they cut off? How did they get cut off? The lockdown dating back to 2020. It's been 2 years. They haven't been able to function in full capacity. All right. They've incurred a lot of losses. They've had to fire a lot of people. And right now they're rallying together to fight back. Now, this fight is in vain, because I'll be shocked if it gets to the Supreme Court. But even if it does, it's going to fail miserably, because all the three branches of government in the U.S. are bought and paid for. The corruption has been there since 1913. So you're wasting your time. You know, us as Israelites, I'm happy to hear this. I mean, it makes us very elated, because, again, I mean, I'm not foolish to cheer for my enemies. You know what I'm saying? The enemy of my enemy is not my friend, because they're both my enemies and they're both of the same nation. You know what I'm saying? So Jeremiah 15, 16, cut off the sword from Babylon and him that handleth the sickle in the time of harvest. Those are the lockdowns. It says, for fear of the oppressing sword, they shall turn everyone to his people. The oppressing sword is what we've been dealing with from medical martial law, which we've been under medical martial law for the past 2 years, then back to 2019. And now we about to enter into military martial law, because with everything that's going on now, fall is coming. A lot of people's immune system have been totally destroyed. And when fall comes in and the winter comes in, it's going to get really awful out here. It's going to be bad. And then when you add the propaganda that's going to come out of the mainstream, the U.S. mainstream media, big tech, you know what I'm saying, places like the YouTube and Twitter and all these different places, they're going to move in lockstep with the propaganda. So you already know the FEMA camps are ready, concentration camps is ready, and a lot of people, you know, the majority, you know, you Negroes, Hispanics, and Native Americans are going to be thrown into these camps. A lot of you that don't even, you know, yes, you're denying this thing, but you don't even know why you're denying it. So you're going to end up in there. And, you know, but the ones of us who understand, we understand, hey, if we're going to end up in there, we're going to end up in there. It is what it is, a part of prophecy. And we're going to welcome that, because it takes us further and further down that place where we need to be. All right, which is a transition, which is the exodus, the final exodus of the nation of Israel out of captivity. It says, and they shall flee everyone to his own land. Let me see. So now let me go to Isaiah 19 and 15. It says, neither shall there be any work for Egypt. Egypt is another code word in Isaiah 19. Egypt represents these United States. And you said, well, how? Because it's spiritual symbolism. Just, we always say it's easy. Go to your dollar. Your dollar bill has what? Egyptian symbolism all over. From, I mean, here in the nation's capital, right? We have the monument, which is an Egyptian obelisk. I mean, you would see that in the dollar. You would see the All Seeing Eye. You would see Eye of Horus, which is all Egypt. You know, that's Egyptology. 101, all these deities in the dollar, which represents a talisman, you know, a currency of witchcraft, all right? But those symbolisms are from ancient Egypt. Why? Because a lot of the power source of the U.S., you know, beginning with the priest class of the elites, is really based on ancient idol worship from the different nations, from Egypt, you know, which is in the Hebrew Matazarium, to Canaan, which are the so-called South Africans today. All these different beliefs, you know. So Egypt is one of them. So Isaiah 19 and 15, neither shall there be any work for Egypt, a.k.a. the U.S., which the head or tail branch and or rush may do. Why? Because the reason why it says head and tail branch and rush, because it matches up with Revelation 13, right? When you get to the next step, when the mark of the beast, which we know to be the RFID microchip, when it gets established, it still talks about rich and poor, you know, free or bond. It's talking about the head and tail. So that's how you know it's talking about the same place. Now, talking about ancient Egypt, okay? This is, I wanted to read one of the Bible versions, and it says right here in the NIV, no, not the NIV. Well, really, I like the NIV because remember the statement that I said, the statement that I made was that these 200 businesses that are trying to fight against these draconian measures and mandates, they're wasting their time. They're wasting their time. They think they can help Egypt. But this is what the scripture says. Look at what it says in the NIV. There is nothing Egypt can do, head or tail, right? Upper middle class, lower middle class, palm, branch, or reed, right? It says, what's that? ESV, and there would be nothing for Egypt that head or tail, palm, and branch, branch or reed may do. Ain't shit you gonna be able to do about this. This is called tyranny. This is called total takeover. This is called build back better, lockstep. You know, mainstream media with big tech moving one, you know, moving in unison with a message, with a narrative, and, you know, trying to get the minds of the zombies, you know, which, you know, the majority of you so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Native Americans are part of those zombies, right, along with a lot of the nations, right? Edom, beginning with Edom, Esau, and Elam, and all of these nations that are here in the U.S., all 18 nations represented. So you got a whole mass of zombies that need to be brainwashed, and the elites, they understand that, but the elites also understand that you will have a pushback. They've already put all of that into consideration, thus the FEMA camps, because they've already known that they're not idiots. When you do something that drastic and something that draconian, it's something that wicked and evil, you should expect a pushback, because there's always going to be that balance in the world, a light and a darkness. So the darkness is moving right now, so it's expecting pushback from the light. All right, so that's we understand that. So now I'm gonna wrap up with Ecclesiastes chapter 12 verse 1. It says, "Remember now thy creator in the days of thy youth." It's talking about Israel. All right, it says, "While the evil days come not, nor the years draw nigh when thou shalt say, I have no pleasure in them." Right. So this is the time for you to turn back. And you should have been turned back, but this is definitely the time to turn back to Yahweh Bashem El Shai. And don't wait till all the fun is taken out. Don't wait till all the fun is taken out. Because if you wait for all, when all the fun is taken out, then you wasting, then you playing games with the Most High. All right. You got to make sacrifices, man. You can't enjoy everything and then say, well, nah, I've enjoyed the whole world. I got everything that the world had to offer. So now, you know what I'm saying? So now let me just go and serve the Lord. Yeah, you can't play games with the Lord, man. So now it says, let me see. "While the sun or the light or the moon and the stars be not darkened, nor the clouds return after the rain. In the day when the keepers of the house shall tremble, and the strong men shall bow themselves, and the grinders cease because they are few, And those that look out of the windows be darkened. Yeah, those are procrastinators, guys, that tell you about how the economy is going to rebound and all that craziness. Ain't going to be none of that. You know what I'm saying? Ain't going to be none of that. Verse 4, and the doors shall be shut in the streets. Like, those are the doors of what? Business is going to be shut in the streets, man. The backbone of the U.S. All right, it says, and the doors shall be shut in the streets when the sound of the grinding is low, and he shall rise up at the voice of the bird, and all the daughters of music shall be brought low. So all that entertainment stuff is being brought low. Even football, as it is, I do not envision a full season of football. I definitely do not envision a full season of basketball. I believe that these things are going to be cut short right in the middle, which that's how it usually is. The element of surprise and is very important in establishing these plans that the elites have. So they got to let you believe that things are going to be smooth when things are not going to be smooth. And they're going to cut these things, you know, halfway through, you know. And you got a lot of guys in the entertainment that are bailing out. They're bailing out from these things like NBA, football. So people going to have to make some decisions, man. And that's going to force this whole thing to just go on a total shutdown. So it's going to be entertaining. I can't wait. You know, I'm very, very happy through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashem El Shai that things are turning for the worse in Babylon, you know, because everything that's worse for Babylon is great for us, the Israelites, the hopeful elect. So with that, I'm going to say, Kar Halam La Yahweh Bashem El Shai. I'm going to give double honors to our apostles and elders, a great millstone. Shalom, salutation to you, Sensei Akims, across the four winds. You know, stay strong, stay faithful. It's another installment of the Watchtower. Shalom.